This is Ken from DVDO. Today's segment, we're going to unbox an edge green and basically go through a video quick start of the edge green. We'll go through the back panel, the inputs and outputs, and then we're going to connect it to this display here to get an output. Okay, so we got here edge green in the box. Very top, you see the accessory box kit. Open the side, you will see edge green quick start. Okay, warranty card, and you've got a USB cable for firmware updates. Okay. Remote control with batteries and power cord. We're going to need power cord, so let's unwrap this. And we're going to need remote control. Okay. So this inside. For the edge screen. As you can see, it looks very similar. I mean, it looks exactly like the original edge, H101. Okay. So in the front here, you have the IR receivers in this dome here. One difference between the edge green and the edge 101 is that there's no front HDMI port. Well, original edge, this pops down and there's a front HDMI port. Edge green does not have that. On the back side, on the back panel, it is exactly the same. Okay, and I'll just quickly go through. We have 5 HDMI input. Okay, and for the analog video input, you have 2 component video. Okay, the component video can be the second component video can be RGB HV. You have your horizontal and you have vertical sync, RGB HV. Component 1 and component 2 can also be for RGBS. And here's your sync, your S. You have your single composite video in and your S video input. For the audio input, you have one pair of audio in, a coaxial in, and you have 3 optical input. Okay. On the output side, you have an HDMI video audio. This output contains both HDMI video and audio. You have a dedicated HDMI audio, and then you have an optical output, digital audio output. Okay. And here you have your mini USB port for firmware update. And you have your IR input. And this is for your power cord. So that is the back panel of the DVDO edge screen. So now that you've unboxed your DVDO edge screen, let's connect it to the display and get an output from your edge screen to the display. Okay. So we are going to take the HDMI cable, connect it, HDMI port in the back. Okay. And then we're going to connect it to the HDMI video audio output here. Okay. Plug it in.
control. And let's make sure that this is on the right HDMI. Okay, there we go. Let's clear this screen. So when you first connect your edge green to your TV or your display, edge green is going to read through the EDID, the display's EDID. So for example here, it's seeing that the display is a Philips. So here you see the display is Philips. You also can change this as well. Change the name of your display. So let's put just an example of Philips 1. Okay. Okay. And also here, an output format. From default is auto select. Auto select reads the EDID of the display and determines what is the preferred resolution that in the EDID prescribed. EDID is extended display identification data. So in the EDID of this display, it tells the edge green the name of the display and also tells the preferred resolution that in the EDID prescribed. Okay, so that's auto select. You can also manually select an output, a format from VGA up to SXGA. But as you can see, we also have 1080p 60, 1080p 50 hertz, 1080p 24 hertz as well. Okay, but we can just leave it in auto select for now. And then you can also here select what type, where the audio comes out from the DVDO edge green. So in this section, we can select video, HDMI, audio HDMI, or the optical. In auto select, what that does is that it will automatically select between video and audio by determining what is connected to the video HDMI and or audio HDMI. If there's nothing connected to the audio HDMI, it will output audio through the video HDMI. If a component is connected to the audio HDMI, let's say an AV receiver, then the DVDO edge screen will output audio from the audio HDMI. So one way to use this is that for the audio output, it goes to the AVR. For the video, it goes to display. So if your AVR is in standby or in off, then audio is automatically routed through the video HDMI, which goes to your TV. Once you turn on the AVR, edge green senses that there's a component connected to the audio HDMI port, then it automatically switches audio to the audio HDMI. So how that works is that as you turn on the AVR, then audio comes from your surround sound system automatically. As you turn off your AVR, then audio gets routed to the TV, and the TV will output the audio. Okay. So that's audio output. So what we've done is we've unboxed the DVDO edge green. We looked at the back panel, the inputs and outputs. We've connected the edge green to a TV, able to get an output, went through the display wizard, went through how to rename the display, and went through the output format, and went through the audio output section. Next time, we'll connect the source through the DVDO edge screen, and we'll get the source processed through the DVDO edge screen and have it display on your TV. Hi, welcome back. This is another chapter of the DVDO edge screen quick start video guide. Remember last time we went through the edge screen, we unboxed it, look at the back panel, look at the connections on the back, and we connected the edge screen to TV, We got output from the end screen to the TV, and we briefly went through the menus structure of the edge screen, as you see here. Today we're going to connect a source into the edge screen. We're going to use one of the HDMI input on the back. The source that we've selected is PS3. Looks very familiar, right? This PS3 has an HDMI out, so we can connect the PS3 to the edge screen via HDMI. Okay. So, we're going to need an HDMI cable, connect the output of the PS3 into one of the HDMI input of DVDO edge screen. Remember, DVDO edge screen has 5 HDMI input, and we're going to use HDMI input number 1. Let's add power to the PS3. Okay, turn it on. There you have it. You got the PS3 signal going out into the DVDO edge screen, and the edge screen is outputting to the TV. Okay, and that's your basic hookup of a source into the DVDO edge screen. So now that we connected the PS3 into the DVDO edge screen, let's just confirm what we have so far. If you press the info button on the remote control, what's going to come up is your input status. So as you can see, we're on HDMI 1, and we are receiving 1080p from the PS3. The PS3 is set up so that it will give the best resolution from its HDMI into the DVDO edge screen. And right now it's outputting 1080p. And let's also confirm what we have for output. The output status, we are outputting 1080p to the TV. Okay? There's some things that you want to set up in your source. You try to set up your source so that your source will output the native format of the content that you are playing back. Let's say, for example, for DVD, you want to set up your source so that the source will output for standard DVD either 480i or 480p. Okay, so specifically to the PS3, you can go into the menu structure, the settings of the PS3, and make sure that it does not scale DVD content. And I believe it's in video settings, and you're going to go to BD DVD upscaler. So you want that off. The reason you want that off is you want the edge screen to do all the video processing, and you want to minimize or eliminate any video processing in the source. So, you know, since you have the state-of-the-art video processor, you want the edge screen to do the processing. You want it to do the work, okay? So we turn the upscaler off in this PS3. If it was just a normal DVD player, then you want to make sure that the DVD player outputs either 480i or 480p. Okay. If it's a Blu-ray player, then a lot of Blu-ray players have a direct mode. Well, you want to enable that direct mode so that the Blu-ray player will output the native format of the content you're watching. Okay. So we can put in, what I just did is put in a standard DVD, and let's just make sure that we are actually getting 480i or 480p from the PS3. And press the info button once it comes on. And go to input status, and we're getting 480p from the PS3. So the PS3 is not upscaling the standard DVD content, okay? Just want to quickly go through what we can do on the input controls. Pitch controls, you can control the brightness, contrast, saturation, hue, YC delay, detail enhancement, edge enhancement, mosquito noise reduction, and chroma upsampling error correction on source. And these controls are per input. So you have separate settings for each of the input that's on the back of DVDO Edge Green. Okay. Another thing that you should also want to do is to correctly assign the audio with the video. Okay. So currently we have the PS3 connected to the DVDO Edge Green via HDMI. Both video and audio is through that HDMI cable. So we just want to confirm that the audio, that we're getting audio through the HDMI. So we go to settings, go to audio settings, and we go to audio input, and we selected HDMI. Okay. So audio from HDMI is being used along with the video via HDMI. Of course, you have other selection as well. Let's say that you want to use the optical out from the PS3, right? The audio from the optical out from the PS3, you can assign one of the optical. So you can take the optical out from the PS3 into one of the three optical in on the DVDO Edge Green and assign the optical input that way. Okay. So that's just a quick run through of connecting a source into the DVDO Edge Green. Thank you for joining me for another chapter in the DVDO Edge Green Quick Start Video Guide. My name is Ken Nguyen with DVDO, and I'll see you next time.